So the web server checks really like, okay, this is a ColdFusion website. Okay, I cannot do anything with this. So he sends this request onwards to the ColdFusion server for processing. And the ColdFusion server can do all this stuff because that's what it's designed for. It's nice to come across these errors because then you see that even I do mistakes. Hey YouTube, welcome back to the actual tutorial, or first tutorial lesson of ColdFusion. In this tutorial, I would like to first explain how a web request from your web browser is done and how it's actually working with ColdFusion or any other server router, but ColdFusion it is. As in the presentation, I use a website called smilebringergames.com. And I made tutorials there, ColdFusion tutorials, lesson one here. This is this page I'm showing you. I made a little presentation so you can have a look into how things are working really. So let me just change scenes here. ColdFusion tutorial, how do website requests actually work? So that is whenever you type in an address in your browser and you press enter, or on your phone, of course, the same thing. If you type in search and you find something and you click on a link in Google, you're like, I want to check this website or I want to check this Facebook page. What happens then? I'll show you now right away. You type an address or you click a link or whatever in your email. And as you see, I put the same tutorial page up here. You type an address in the bar in top, or you type a link, you have a link to a Facebook profile you want to check out. And then the browser, there's a little bit more than this only. It actually also, it checks for the domain name what you're requesting, and it goes through a lot of like things like name server and DNS and all that stuff. But we just skip ahead on that one. Afterwards, you end up at an address of a web server, that is an IP address in this case. So the browser sends this request to the web server, and that's the blue box I put in there. There. The web server is usually not really capable of any form of programming language other than serving you HTML websites. So the web server has to be configured to also serve other programming language websites. So the browser sends the request to the web server for index.cfm. And the web server says, okay, we have to find index.cfm. Oh, this is a ColdFusion website. So now I have to send this on to a ColdFusion server. So the web server checks really like, okay, this is a ColdFusion website. Okay, I cannot do anything with this. This is not an HTML page. I cannot send an HTML page back. I cannot send the ColdFusion page back because then you would see the code. Would not be a good idea. So he sends this request onwards to the ColdFusion server for processing, and the ColdFusion server can do all this stuff because that's what it's designed for. Sometimes certain ColdFusion code can require also a database, and it will then look up stuff in the database, so you have like this kind of traffic, database server requests, and asks for information, so it can display this. Just for example, your Facebook friend list, you know, all those names and so on. It requests, not a ColdFusion server on Facebook though, requests information to database server, and database server, these are all your friends. And then it sends it back to the ColdFusion server, and then it will display this on a page. So the ColdFusion server makes HTML from your code. And then when the HTML is processed, the HTML is sent back to the web server. And the web server, well, the web server just returns it back to the web browser, so that you see the page on your browser. So let's now go back to my first lesson page. This is the page that I very quickly and with very bad coding have made. I didn't put much time into making a nice design here yet. It might be changed by the time you're getting here, but at least right now it's just a white page, and I put it with a center, and I put some enters here, hard returns on the top. It says, welcome to lesson one. Today it is Thursday, and I made Thursday bold here for a reason, because tomorrow it will actually say it's Friday and so on. Part one of lesson one is to explain you how the execution of code and the request process of your browser to the web server works. That we just did. Part two of this lesson is to show you some basic and quick functionality within ColdFusion. So I want to show you how I did this page. For that, I will just go to the code. I use Visual Studio Code. It's a free IDE. IDE stands for Interface Development Environment. Not sure. Anyway, it is a very good editor. You don't see previews of code, although I think you can anyway if you connect it to your own web server locally. Right now it's just for code. I'm using it for code, so you can see this is basically an HTML page all the way. The only thing that is called Fusion in here is right in here. So it's called Fusion code is inside CF output tags. As my mouse over also says, displays output that can contain the result of processing CFML variables and functions. You can use the query attribute to loop over the result set of a database query. Well, it gives you a little bit more information than you would like to know, but CF output has indeed also a query variable which you can use to output a database, but I'm not going into that right now. So CF output is a requirement to output code, and also these hash signs, as they are called, should be around functionality for ColdFusion. Straight away, a little notification in HTML and especially CSS, if you have like a color code, you have like this sign, the hash code or the number sign. And then you have like, for example, FF0000, that's for example red. This you will have in HTML at times, and you will come across this later on in ColdFusion coding, I'm sure. This will go wrong within the CF output sign. So to be able to display still or to use the red color coding in within a CF output, you'll have to use double hash to escape it so it doesn't get executed. So I can show you that one. As you can see here now, today it is hashtag first day. Within the CF output, you can also have hashtags displayed or used for like color coding if you escape it with a double hash, like I did here. That was only a little bit sidetrack, but it's very important. And here we have a function in ColdFusion. It's called date format. It formats a date. Now I could have done just the now function. The now function gives the date, but as you see, the date comes out as a time coding with the full date in American reverse order, so to say, and the full 24-hour clock time in a very special tagline here with these accolades on it. But I wanted to only display the day itself, so that's why there is date format. It takes the current date. You can also put a date in here, and this is the formatting. It says 1D or 1D is like the date, the, well, what is it today, the 9th, so there will be 9. 2Ds means 09, and 3Ds means the abbreviation for first day will be THU, I think, or maybe THURS, I'm not sure. We can test it. We can test this. Yeah, THU for first day, 2, and yeah, and 4 of them means the full first day, the full day name. This can also be changed again by using local standard coding, because then you can have, like, if you're Norwegian and I'm living in Norway, I could have the Norwegian equivalent of first day, which is torsdag, And in Dutch it would be donderdag, and in Germany it would be donnerstag, and so on. You could use it in different languages, but that is a little bit advanced. Let's not go into that one right now. As you can see, it's very easy. It can just display all sorts of information here. We could add more functionality. This first slash margin actually meant to be about variables, but let's not go into them right now yet. I just want to show you the different functions you can have displayed on your screen. Similarly, I could also do something like time format. It takes a time, which I will take on now, and then it will take a formatting, which is like hour, minute. Can also do seconds. I have to close the hashtag like that, and then it works. That 22.5. Use the same time format like this time format now, still the current time. Then it uses, like, for example, HHMM. This will display hour as in 24 hour and minutes. As you can see, now it's 22.06. A minute later, time goes on. I do notice that it's not the same time as my time. That has to do with, because it's actually 11 here. This has to do because of the server is probably configured an hour in the past, like maybe in England or something. Although the server is in Hamburg. But then again, I might have not set the time zone properly on the server, so that is the reason why it shows 22.06. So I would like to also go into variables quickly in this lesson. I will do that in part 3 of this lesson. Let's program some standard HTML. Dirty way of programming, but well. Part 3 of this first lesson is to show how variables work. Now we're getting really into the ColdFusion coding. The advantage of ColdFusion, the normal language code, like the tag-based code, is that it doesn't need to per se to be in a separate file. It can be in the HTML file. That is, it is still an index.cfm file, but I can basically put codes here right in here. Most tags start with cf in as a beginning, so you type cf. So now we're going to do a variable that is cf set for a variable. We'll set a variable, so cf set, and then we make the variable name that is like variable name is or equals, and if it's a number of variable, I can just put a number in like this. If it is like a string, I just put quotes around it, and I can make variable number 2. To display these variables on ColdFusion, cf output, then we can say variable 1, and then we do var name in there, and then we break that one, variable 2. I just do this to make it easier for you to understand which one is which. So if I now show this on the website, you'll see how that looks like. Something you don't see is that I also upload these files to the server, so you can actually see them. So variable 1 is 1, and variable 2 is variable number 2. So this is a string, and this is a number. That means also that we can do calculations and all that sort of stuff, so let's also play with that. 1 plus 2. I think that works that way. And to give you an extra example, actually I think I should just free is run name plus 2. Yeah, because this doesn't want 1, right? So var name 1. Maybe I should also do that to make it a little bit more easier to see. So var name 1 is 1, var name 2 is variable number 2, var name 3 is var name 1, which is 1, plus 2, and this should in theory give you 3, right? We hope so, at least. Variable 3, var name 3. The useful thing of this editor, I can actually just type and it will automatically fill in for me. And variable number 4 is going to be var name 4. It's not made yet, but I will show you in a minute. We're going to make var name 4 is, we're gonna combine var name 2 and another string, so then I can still use var name 2 there. We'll have to use a different sign, I believe, like that, and then type here and variable name 4 is this. So as you can see, variable number 3 is 3, that is like variable number 1 is 1 plus value of 2, which he automatically calculates to number 3, and hence it is number 3. Variable 4, I combined the variable 2, which is variable number 2, in here, and then I added this piece of text to it. So you can also combine variables that way. So what can you do really with it? Well, you can put stuff, information in variables. It doesn't have to be, of course, like typed. It can also be like coming from a database. So what you can do as well with this is like CFZ. I just put var in front of it to make it sure that you understand that this is a variable. So I could make a title like this title here. I could make into a ColdFusion variable. I could remove them from there. I could put it in this variable. So now it says ColdFusion tutorial lesson 1. And then I could output the var title within the good idea to also use the output thing, output tags. So then we can put here var title, so, and now it will output the var title here in the title tag, and the title tag you see above your page. You can also put it here. I could also, for the better explanation, I could put in header 1 here and also put it here, the var title. Just make sure you also output it. So, oh, and now I throw an error. Why did I get this error? I'll explain you in a second. It's because ColdFusion processes these pages from top to bottom. So here I am asking for displaying var title, while var title is not declared yet. It's not here until here, and then 24 that I put var title on. So what I should be doing is put var title, the line 24, into, well, line 1, for example, and then it will show here and there. It's nice to come across these errors, because then you see it, even I do mistakes. So now you see here, here in the tutorial, ColdFusion tutorial lesson 1, and now also here the header to ColdFusion tutorial 1, lesson 1. And this is coming from not variable that we set per title. Can you do much more with it? Yeah, of course you can do much more, but I think I'll keep it to this. Now I have explained really much about the basics of ColdFusion, how the requests work between your browser, the web server, the ColdFusion server, and possibly a database server, and I'm back to you again. Every time you send a page, every time you click on a link. I also explained to you some basic functionality. I showed you how these dates and times are displayed and what you can do with it. I have shown you how variables work and how to set them and how you can combine them. I have explained how to set a var title in the wrong place of a document so that you get a nice error on your screen, and I've improved my mistake and show you how to actually fix it again. So now that you have seen that, it's time to for you to go to lesson number 2. Like this content, be sure to subscribe and click the bell for notification that you get all the updates on my new tutorials when they're released. And if you have questions, please leave them in the comments, and I will answer them for you. I gladly do so. I am also on Twitter and on Twitch. I stream from time to time, so you can check me out there as well. I'm working on a web-based RPG game, text-based, if you like that kind of stuff. And from time to time, you will also see me playing something like Minecraft. So be sure to check me there as well if you want to see more of my content. Otherwise, see you next time in lesson number 2.